Hello everyone, welcome back again to FN Engineering channel. Today, we are going to discuss 5 thickness calculation based on international standard ESME B31.1 for power piping. In this video, we will learn some important things in calculating pipe thickness, including reference, formula, parameter, assumption, and study cases. Well, here are the overviews of this explanation. First of all, we will know the application or scope of works of ESME B31.1 standards. Then, we will determine the reference for pipe thickness calculation using ESME B31.1 standard. Next, we will find the formula for the calculation. After that, we will detail the formula to know the symbols and their definition from the formula. Then, we will know some parameters from the database, such as joint efficiency, lower stress, weld strength factor, and coefficient. Finally, we will practice some study cases to calculate pipe thickness based on ESME B31.1 standard. Go to the next slide. In this slide, we will know the application of ESME B31.1. In general, ESME B31.1 is applied in some equipment such as piping in electrical power generating stations, industrial and institutional plants. Then, it is also used in piping in geothermal heating systems and also used in piping in central and district cooling systems. Here is the illustration of application ESME B31.1. We use ESME B31.1 in piping with indicated by thick allows. Meanwhile, for the thin allow, we use ESME section 1. In addition, for dotted allows, we use other standards. Go to the next slide. In this slide, we will know some use reference for thickness calculation. The use main reference is in paragraph 104.1.2, equation 7. In addition, we need some data from the database for pipe dimension. We refer to ESME B36.10 standards. Meanwhile, for the material properties and joint efficiency, we use table A in mandatory appendix A. In table A, it is uses US customary unit, so we have to convert for the metric unit. Then, we use table 102.4.71 to determine the weld strength factor. And finally, we also use table 104.1.21 to determine the coefficient. In the next slide, we will know the formula for pipe thickness calculation, refer to paragraph 104.1.2, equation 7. Here is the formula. The formula is for calculating the minimum required thickness. Well, next, we will describe the definition of each symbol from this formula. First, TM. TM is the minimum required thickness in millimeter unit. Then P. P is the internal distance pressure in MPa unit. Next, there is DO. DO is the outside diameter of the pipe in millimeter unit. After that is S. S is lower stress of pipe material in MPa unit. We can find S value from table A in appendix A. Then E. E is joint efficiency. The value of joint efficiency can also be found in table A1. Next, W. W is weld strength factor, referred to table 102.4.71. After that, Y. Y is coefficient, based on table 104.1.21. Lastly, is A. A is the corrosion allowance in millimeter unit. Go to the next slide. In this slide, we will show the reference some data from the database. First, it is the reference for the join efficiencies. We can determine join efficiency factor or E for welding design, and also casting factor or F for casting design. In this table, we can also know additional information, such as grade material, chemical composition of the material, P number, specified minimum tensile strength, and specified minimum yield strength. Then, we will find the allowable stress. The allowable stress value can be obtained in table A1. We can see in the table, the allowable stress value is influenced by design temperature. It is the same with the SME section 2D. In the next reference, it is the weld strength factor. We can determine W or weld strength factor based on table 102.4.71. In general, W value will be decreased when the design temperature is increasing. For lower temperature surfaces or below 400 degrees Celsius, W value is 1. Well, in this slide, it is for coefficient or Y. The coefficient value can be obtained from table 104.1.21. You can see in the table, the Y value is influenced by the type of material and design temperature. Well, turn on to the study cases. We will solve 3 study cases for pipe thickness calculation. In the first study case, we will determine the nominal thickness of the pipe with some given information, such as pipe material using SA106 grade B and pipe dimension using nominal pipe schedule 10 inch. Then, for design condition, internal design pressure is 1000 kPa and internal design temperature is 100 degrees Celsius. Secondly, we will also determine the nominal thickness of the pipe with some given information. Pipe material is stainless steel. Material using SA312 GP304 NPS 4 inch and welded pipe. Meanwhile, the design condition are design pressure 2 MPa and design temperature 200 degrees Celsius. In the last study case, we will also calculate the nominal thickness for the tube. The tube is typically used for heat transfer. The material for the tube in this study case is carbon steel or SA179 with an OSA diameter 1 inch. Meanwhile, the design condition is the same as the second study case, design pressure 2 MPa and design temperature 200 degrees Celsius. We will solve the study case one by one. First, we will explain in more detail for study case 1. We have given parameters based on question, such as internal design pressure 1000 kPa or 1 MPa, design temperature 100 degrees Celsius, and material using SA106 grade B. Next, S, all allowable stress. S can be obtained from table A1. For carbon steel material, we can see the value is 15.1 KSI. We convert to metric, will be 117.9 MPa. Then, we find the outside diameter for nominal pipe schedule 10 inch. From ESMEB 36.10, the value is 273 mm. After that, we find the joint efficiency value from table A1 for carbon steel material, which is 1. Then, we assume a corrosion allowance, or A, 3 mm for carbon steel material. After that, we find the weld joint factor and coefficient from table 102.4.71 and table 104.1.21 respectively. The value are 1 for weld joint factor and 0.4 for coefficient. After we define all parameters, we can calculate the minimum required thickness or GM based on the formula in equation 7. We get 4.15 mm for the minimum required thickness. In the next step, we determine the nominal thickness of the pipe based on the minimum required thickness value. We use schedule 40 or 9.27 mm for safe design. So, the finished thickness is 8.11 mm. The value is still larger than the minimum required thickness. Therefore, the nominal thickness is acceptable. Well, we have solved study case 1. Secondly, we will solve the study case 2. Study case 2 is stainless steel pipe or SA312TP304 welded with design data 2 MPa and design temperature 200 degrees Celsius. The allowable stress for this material is 15 KSI or 103.4 MPa. Refer to table A3 for stainless steel material. The outside diameter for nominal pipe schedule 4 inch is 114.3 mm. Then, the joint efficiency is 1, refer to table A3 for stainless steel material. Next, we assume a corrosion allowance 0 mm for stainless steel material. Then, we get the same value as per study case 1 for weld joint factor and coefficient, which are 1 and 0.4. In the next step, we can calculate the minimum required thickness, or GM. We get 1.1 mm. Next, we determine the nominal thickness. We assume the nominal thickness is using schedule 10, or 3.05 mm. So, the finished thickness is 2.67 mm. The thickness is acceptable because the finished thickness, 2.67 mm, is larger than the required thickness, 1.1 mm. Well, we have solved study case 2. Lastly, we will solve study case 3 for the minimum required thickness for the tube. The given data is design pressure 2 MPa, design temperature 200 degrees Celsius, material using SA179, and outside diameter 25.4 mm. Next, we get allowable stress from table A1, 13.4 KSI, or 92.4 MPa. Joint efficiency is also 1 from table A1. Then, we assume 0 mm for corrosion allowance, because there is no corrosion allowance for the tube. Weld joint factor, or W, is 1, and coefficient, or Y, is 0.4. Next, we can calculate the minimum required thickness, or GM. We get 0.27 mm for the minimum required thickness. In the next step, we determine the nominal thickness of the tube. The tubes have thickness standards, such as BWG standards. Based on BWG standards, we assume the tube thickness is
BWG-18 or 10245 mm. Then we determine the finished thickness of the tube. If the tube uses average wall thickness, the finished thickness shall consider tube under tolerance 12.5%. Meanwhile, if the tubes use minimum wall thickness, the tube under tolerance is not required. We assume the tube specification is average wall thickness in this case. So, the finished thickness is 1.09 mm. Based on this value, the tube nominal thickness BWG-18 is acceptable. Well, we have solved all study cases. To summarize, we get the nominal thickness 9.27 mm or schedule 40 for study case 1, 3.05 mm or schedule 10 for study case 2, and 1.245 mm or BWG-18 for study case 3. Alright everyone, thank you for watching my video. If you have some comments or suggestion, please write on the comment column. And if you get something new from this video, please like my video, subscribe to my channel, and turn on the notification from this channel to get an updated video from FN Engineering channel. And don't forget to share this video or FN Engineering channel with others. See you next time!